getting past the 1.5. Is there a special rendezvous point for the cars to park afterwards?
Yeah. Did that...
Scrapyard.
Like it.
Yeah, they're all going to be parked up at the Plasters Exposition.
Achieve your ton?
No, I've kept it off that, to be honest. I haven't got.
A spare motor to get home on?
No, it's not that. Yeah. It is not worth upsetting ACO by having a whoopsie. And these tyres are what's known in this country as taxi radials.
It's God, yeah, I've got them on my drop-in coupe. Yeah, they're terrible things.
Yeah.
Well, you gave it a good nudge.
Yeah, I mean, we had, I was going on, obviously the speedo reads low, but going on the tacker, we did it, we certainly did 90. If we get a tyre blow or something like that, you know, that's going to be seriously unpopular.
Well, the taxi tyres definitely were not designed for this type of work.
No.
How's your video? You're getting it all on?
I've got a clue.
You haven't got a
clue. Try to hold it.
I'd be delighted to pay for a copy if you can do it.
Well, if what I've got in mind is there's a laddie that lives easy distance from me, about 10 miles away, who's a retired news film man, film studio guy, and everything else. He does it to top his pension up and keep himself amused, and he does all the usual.
Careful what you say, because if he goes on this and he says you call an old pensioner, he's not really very impressive by his scrappy film.
You got that running, haven't you?
Yeah, because I've got it running. What are you doing with a video? What are you doing with a video? Just look through for the fun of it.
He's a nice lad, is he?
Yeah,
he's got to be now.
He made up the...
Good boy. Don't get upset.
Yeah, we took some video of London to Edinburgh run. And he turned that into quite a decent little video for us.
Good.
And we were able to make a small number of copies of it. Came out of that £14 a time.
But on the other hand, you might disown me by tonight.
Oh, I doubt it very much. Car in front, Kurt.
Yep.
That's Gilbert Grace and his daughter. And he's had that from new, and that's a full race spec in that.
Is it really?
Yeah. And he used to race it. And his father used to race the Pathfinder and the 2.5 before him, which was Harold Grace. But it's far too much work to even be in with a prayer of getting it street legal, never mind anywhere near.
You've got the roadster.
I've got a roadster kit.
Okay. Come in just third.
More or less, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, somebody bought it in the mid-60s for about £45, I think. And did a lot of the a fair bit of mechanical work on it. And circumstances changed and he wasn't able to carry on. And back in the 70s, he decided to move it on. And that's when I bought it. And I haven't done anything with it since I've had it.
Familiar story amongst the Riley clan.
Yeah. You can tell it's a bit hot, a bit cammy.
I bought a Riley Red Wing in 1967. And only 2 years ago pulled it out.
Yeah?
And started restoring it.
Oh, right.
So yeah. That's a... But I've been sort of sidetracked a little bit because on December the 5th, I bought a Brooklyn that's never seen light of day for 47 years.
Oh.
And it's complete Ulster TT specs. With an Ulster TT motor and a lot.
Oh.
And the chap that had it, in the 47 years he owned it, only had it out and driven it once.
Good heavens. The way these older cars don't like the hotter temperatures, first thing in the morning was a good
choice.
Yeah. Bonjour.